Hello, my loyal subjects. Heather Blossom here, and I've trekked back to the Nine Circles of Hell to deliver pony content that no one asked for. In the form of a top 10 list, cause every pony loves those. The topic today being one I'm shocked I haven't seen anyone do yet. Rarity, the mayor, the myth, the legend. It's a pony with a large wardrobe, a walk-in closet, and a storage unit in Manhattan, and a warehouse in Saudi Arabia. The point being, she's a dame with a lot of clothes. Makes sense, being Equestria's premier fashionista and drama queen, that she goes through quite a few costume changes throughout the run of My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic. Whether it's her next fashion show, tea time in Ponyville, or even saving the world, this girl has got an outfit for every occasion. Which means, with this litany of options that were presented in Gen 4's run, there were bound to be ones that the fans of the show love more than others, me included. So I thought, why not rank these fits and determine which one reigns supreme? For me. Your experience may vary, but stick around, I might just show you some looks you might have forgotten. It was pretty dang difficult to cut this list to just 10, but luckily prior to this script writing, I hosted a poll for my patrons and subscribers to participate in. For all that voted, thank you. This isn't one-to-one to how the tallied votes landed, but it helped me make some of the harder decisions. But before I get too far into it, I want to take a moment for some honorable mentions, them being all of Rarity's hats.
Whether mysterious, glamorous, or applejackalicious.
Let me just lay it straight for you guys. You may disagree, but a hat is not an outfit, which is why none of these made the cut. A hat can be the central focus in an ensemble, for sure, but a hat itself is more an accessory to a larger piece. We are focusing on a full look here, a fully clothed look, meaning Rarity with the Crystal Empire filter or Rarity as a sea pony don't make the list either. Without further ado, let's begin.
Number 10.
At number 10, I want to feature a look from the very first season of My Little Pony: Friendship is Magic. This fit came from the episode Boastbusters, which you might recognize as the episode where we met the fan favorite, the great and powerful Trixie. But Rarity, never to be upstaged, showcased this piece as a response to Trixie's challenge, and boy, does it make a statement. In that moment, Rarity asserted what it really means to be a unicorn, as opposed to Trixie's approach of raw power and bravado. Our generous hero encountered that this view was two-dimensional, and that a unicorn should exemplify beauty and grace. She demonstrates this by adorning a long, elegant gown with gold accents, a long ruffled neckline, and beehive hairstyle. I want to focus in on those last two features a moment because I'll bet you never realized just how timeless those characteristics are. Ruffles have made a mark on fashion from as far back as the 16th century, from being a unisex accent to landing more on the feminine in recent generations. Beehives also have a long history, the style Rarity sports here looking like a mix between Audrey Hepburn from Breakfast at Tiffany's and Patsy Stones from Absolutely Fabulous. Which, side note, I need to pick apart for voice lines because if she isn't a manic jaded Rarity, I don't know what is.
What will you drink if you stop drinking?
I should drink water. It's a mixer, Patsy, we have it with whiskey.
What do you know what it's like? I mean, you've given up drinking before.
Worst 8 hours of my life.
The point being, Rarity doesn't just follow trends, she understands the cycles that are involved in styling, staying ahead of the curve by developing a taste for timeless looks. I also want to point out she did this in 5 seconds with nothing but a curtain. She made this absolute banger fit with a curtain, which just makes Trixie's actions here all the more heinous.
No! Green hair! Not green hair! Such an awful...
Number 9.
Number 9 was an option that received a significant amount of votes in my online poll. Why so low then? Well, it was tied with several other options, and it's debatable whether Rarity even wore this thing, since it came from the episode PPOV, Pony Point of View, and Applejack's retelling of events that led to their shipwreck. Now, this totally would be a thing in Rarity's wardrobe, so I'll let that slide. Not to mention it perfectly suits the occasion since it was very clearly Rose's ensemble from Titanic, Gainsborough hat and all. If Rarity did wear this to a boat outing, girl was clearly tempting fate, but again, that is all hearsay. I don't remember catching this reference when originally watching this episode myself, but from what I can tell, this fit has been living rent-free in many a brony's mind since then, and that is deserving of a spot on this list.
Number 8.
Number 8 is the one you know, you love, and you probably thought of first when you saw this video. Yes, I'm talking about Rarity's Grand Galloping Gala Gown, first featured in Suited for Success, then making a brief cameo in A Bird in the Hoof, then lastly, and most famously, in the episode The Best Night Ever. There's no way I could have done a list on this topic and not spoken about this dress. In its debut episode, it perfectly exhibited Rarity's flair for design, the sketch she started with depicting such damn elegance, then to have it sewn together by her friends with newfound appreciation for her profession was a poetic way for it to come to be. I also noticed that it kept with the theme of incorporating timeless trends such as the high ruffle neckline like number 10 had, and a tiara, because tiaras are always in style. Which makes it all rather shocking this ensemble didn't get any higher on the list, but the fact of the matter is, no one voted for it. Being iconic will only get you so far, I guess. Moving on.
Number 7.
Number Lucky 7 is a costume that Rarity didn't design and doesn't necessarily own, that being the superhero suit for Radiance featured in the episode Power Ponies. With the power imbued in the accessories of this suit, she can make attack constructs from tea sets to magic carpets to parasols, the only limit being her imagination. Rarity being a creative makes this limitation a non-issue. The big influence for this design is certainly the Green Lantern, as he has the same power set with a different accessory acting as the conduit, and referencing the MLP trading card even confirms a similar origin. Radiance's power bracelets were gifts from an alien that crash-landed on the planet, except it went on to retire as opposed to just dying like Hal Jordan's alien did. Skill issue. This coolness cannot be attributed to Rarity alone, but I gotta say, she wore it better. I mean, look at the canonical color palette for Radiance. Ugh, what is that? Hiss yellow? Alright, enough of that. Moving on.
Number 6.
Number 6 was really one of my personal favorites. In the episode Sleepless in Ponyville, we get Rarity's version of Roughing It, where she sports an updo paired with sun protection in the form of a headscarf and magenta shades, which can certainly be seen as efficient given the circumstances. Perhaps the same could be said for the shoes if she was actually using them for walking.
Am I sweating? I think I'm sweating!
In any case, this outfit was an absolute treat and another homage to a look famously adorned by Audrey Hepburn. I'm starting to notice a theme here, that adorning Rarity in a Hepburn-inspired look is just a recipe for success. It exudes an amount of extra that is believable. Rarity may be one for theatrics, but not even she's gonna show up to a campsite in a ball gown. Just another example of Rarity's functional yet fashionable approach to life.
Number 5.
Getting into the top 5, this pick originally comes from the episode Green Isn't Your Color from Season 1, and makes an encore appearance in the musical number of Sweet and Elite from Season 2, both instances being just too darn short in my opinion. Look at this pretty peppermint pony gown and tell me it doesn't deserve more time in the spotlight. When looking at this, my first thought was of Candy Stripers. For those unaware, Candy Stripers were young women who volunteered in hospitals back in the 1950s and typically wore aprons bearing the pattern. But I highly doubt Rarity was on her way to do some community service in this getup, and seeing as neither of these episodes were winter-based, I doubt it had to do with candy canes. Instead, I wager this aesthetic choice was symbolic, as Rarity tends to dress in a way that reflects her mood or how she wants to be perceived. And when Rarity first adorns this dress, it's to pick herself up after confessing she was jealous of one of her closest friends receiving more success than she was in her chosen field. Red is often a color associated with passion and valor, like that team on Pokemon Go, while white is usually associated with purity and perfection. These two combined displayed an emotional state that our fair unicorn wanted to embody, to boast her resilience at a tough time but also maintain that her intentions were benevolent, as opposed to the ambivalent vibe she had going on. Overall, a look that only Rarity could rock so hard.
Number 4.
Number 4 is another that got a surprising amount of votes, to the point where it tied with the top rank. Seeing as they can't all win, I had to put it somewhere else. Here is Planity. This was the fit that made an impact as soon as it dropped in the Season 8 episode Friendship University, and I mean I saw people posting cosplays of it later that day. I could say confidently that the cosplay appeal comes in the name. It's plain. Not in a bad way, but in the fact that it is an easy look to replicate, no sewing machine needed. Heck, you might have that blue baseball cap and pink shirt in your closet already. Just hop on over to your local thrift store for a few more pieces, and you have the same fit for $2. You could say the overall look from Simple Ways had the same simplified construction, but I think this ensemble garnered more appeal due to the "hello, fellow foals" persona that came with it. On impact alone, this fit earned its keep.
Number 3.
Number 3 is another personal favorite of mine that did not get nearly enough screen time. In its debut, it was only within a fantasy sequence in the season 1 episode, The Ticketmaster, wherein Rarity outlines her dream night at the Grand Galloping Gala. It wouldn't end up being her gown for that event, but it does make another appearance as a canonical outfit she owns in the becoming popular number of Sweet and Elite. I love this little frilly dress. It's giving Belle's gown from Beauty and the Beast with a complimenting rose motif, but trimmed in a way to adorn a cute pony frame. It worked thematically in both contexts it was presented in. It's original demonstrating Rarity's desire to be acknowledged by the elite as the Belle of the Ball, and in the season 2 sequence it has manifested into reality. Truly, it was not only a gorgeous gown, but a representation of Rarity's hopes and dreams being realized and executed.
Number 2!
Number 2, Our Silver Medal, may surprise you, but I'm sure you were expecting it on this list. Put your hooves together for Punk Rock Rarity! The impact this look had on the fandom blew Planety out of the water. I remember Twitter exploding with fan art of it, either of Rarity's do itself, drawing the rest of the main six with their own version, or getting their OCs in on the craze. My god, I was terrible at drawing! Don't go through my old tweets. This impression is amazing considering the fit was only on display for the last 3 minutes of the episode, which just gives further credence to how moving it was. Rarity would say that Planety was the antithesis of her usual style. And I can see that, but this was so far out of left field from what we expected of her that the whiplash could snap your head off. Not to mention that it's still a pretty simple style to make your own. The hardest part would be the wig, meaning this fit was great cosplay material. Now, onto our last pick.
And finally, number 1!
Number 1. You've waited patiently, but here it is. My pick for the best fit ever adorned by our fabulous fashionista is School Teacher Rarity. This choice will most certainly come across as controversial. Many will say it's just Rarity cosplaying a teacher cliche, others will say it's blatant fan pandering. That drawing is in my history for research purposes only. But if you're into the saucier things, give that artist a follow, 18 plus only. I say you're wrong, except maybe a little bit of the fan pandering, but regardless. This little number is an embodiment of all the positive elements Rarity's previous looks have had. For starters, the reason she even adorned this fit in the first place was due to her emotional state. Being a teacher was not something in Rarity's life planned. It was a job sprung on her by Twilight Sparkle. Way to consider your bestie's schedule as Princess of Friendship, not like we're trying to run an equestria-wide fashion boutique franchise or anything. In the episode School Days itself, our generous proctor even mentioned that she dressed this way because she thought it would help her fill the role more authentically. And though unmentioned, it utilizes calming elements such as cool colors and loose fabrics. It was Rarity's way of feeling as comfortable yet equipped as possible. Speaking of equipped, the efficiency of this outfit is also another plus. The skirt is long, but stays above the ankle, so little risk of tripping. Her mane is up stylishly and out of the way, and then there's the glasses. The lenses may not be apparent, but these are undoubtedly prescription. As shown by literally every time Rarity needs to hem or sew, she typically sports a small pair of red spectacles to help her see the finer details. Just another instance of Rarity's tendencies for fashion and function unification. Lastly, it is another timeless look. You could drop a teacher in this fit from as far back as the early 1900s to present day and not bat an eye. It's the right combination of modest yet inviting that people from any walk of life can agree is appropriate and fetching. All these aspects combined have made this ensemble my number one pick for best outfit. And there you have it, the definitive best outfit list for Rarity, weighed on not only by me, but all my loyal subjects. But I'm sure there's more discussion to be had. Do you agree with this placement, or was there an outfit do you think we slept on? Or, do you think another pony had even better outfits than Rarity? Let me know in the comments below. And while you're there, like, subscribe, and stay fabulous, darlings.